Had an interesting afternoon today with Mike Vegas at Nice Rack Canada, and a representative from TC Electronics was there today handing out free tuners, so we got one of those. And a bit of footage from the demonstration, and you know, that's as good as it gets on a Saturday. Hope you enjoy it. And YouTube's probably going to hate it because I think the guy played some cover tunes. We'll see how that goes, but we'll give it a try anyway. Okay, stand by. Here we go, folks.
Now you have an opportunity.
Pull it down.
I'll talk to you in a moment.
Okay.
Nah, don't worry. It's got a George filter on it.
Nick, me, Jason, Saj.
Actually, it's kind of funny. A friend of mine who used to tour manager.
And Des.
Yeah, I love seeing Saj up front.
Yeah, the guest thing a couple weeks ago at an Ajax, you know, Sebastos and Gokers and stuff. And Andy calls, hey, do you want to do the 20? But the trio, like, we don't really do that.
Am I playing that wrong? Probably right. I can never do that.
He doesn't do it right either. No, he doesn't. He plays it wrong now. It's this. He never goes. He does that. He doesn't go. That's what's on the record. So.
Right.
True.
I'm gonna break the speakers to him.
I think that's.
Yeah. He just missed the.
Okay, I'll play a few questions.
I'm gonna play the face.
Oh, you missed
We sort of hurt.
12 o'clock. On the delay in the chorus, so. So that's the sound that's in the delay right now. So if I want to put, I'll just do what we did earlier. I'll put the Walking on the Moon, which is Andy Summers. We sit down with him and get his. Echoplex sound from that song. So
are those all on your phone now, or they're still in the cloud, right?
They're not in the cloud, no. That's a good point, because once you download the app,
it stays on.
All the sounds are on the phone, so okay. you don't have to be online. It's not Bluetooth and it's not Wi-Fi or anything.
So best to have a 128 gig phone.
When you download the app, does it have all those sounds on the app?
Yeah, they're all in there.
And then you just update as you go.
It self updates. So when you open up the app every time, it checks for new updates. So
does that suck up a lot of data on your phone, though?
No. It's not huge. No, the files are...
It's like metadata, I guess, telling the electronics how to switch. It's like switches. Yeah. It's telling you to switch, right?
So if I want to change that particular delay set, well, first I'll change it to something completely different. I'll put Joe Perry's slap delay in, because it's totally different than this sound. So the sound that's in there right now is a generic type delay. Mm-hmm. So if I want to get Joe Perry's slap in there, you can use any pickup, you just make sure your guitar's turned up. Pedals on in the tone print position, and on the app here you'll see something that says beam to pedal.
Okay.
And you hit that while you hold it over your pickup, and you see the pedal flashing. So you're hearing this fax machine noise and the pedal flashing at the same time. So now you'll have Joe Perry's.
Nice. So the pickup is acting as a microphone, basically.
Yep.
And
there's hundreds of those for different pedals. There's all kinds of different sounds. So we've got Joe Perry, John Petrucci. There's jazz guys, country guys. Albert Lee's in there. There's a ton of.
Can you hear the Andy Summers one?
All right. So let's pop the Andy one back in. So the Andy one, he did two. He did a chorus and a delay. So I'll pop the delay in first. So again, you're going to see the delay on the end flashing.
So just to see how much sounds like a tape.
And then. Okay, so I'll just put it into the chorus as well, but I'll just play the delay only at first here. So here's Andy's chorus, so same kind of thing. This time the Corona chorus pedal is going to flash.
The alter ego is flashing.
I'm so glad it makes that noise.
Yeah. So the file is coded, so it knows what pedal to go into. But some of the other pedals, because the alter ego has modulation on it, so it's picking up some of the modulation information. from the chorus tone print. So it tries to put it into the delay, but they're all coded with their own address, so they know which pedal to go into. So at the end, it can't actually get in. You'll see that there was four red flashes at the end saying it's not gone into that.
Oh, okay.
So here's just the delay itself. So it's got a little bit of breakup on there. I put the chorus on. So this is the two tone prints together. So.
Just walking on the moon. Now you need some compression too.
Okay, yeah. So it's got that swirl, like that's kind of like a little bloomy thing. So that's the concept of the tone prints. You can put in custom sounds designed by the artist.
But what you were saying before is if they're all receptive, they like the signal knows which pedal to go to on a board. It won't fill them all up.
Right. So you don't have to plug and unplug.
Yeah. No.
Just leave your rig the way it is and make it be the rig that you need it to today for the session, for the gig. Whatever.
Sweet.
Yeah, so you can... And the pedals come with, like a lot of customers don't even get to the tone print. The pedals sound great if you don't use tone prints. Especially on this particular delay, it has a whole bunch of vintage styled.
Yeah, so far in the Hall of Fame, I'm only about halfway up the dial. So
yeah, and the Hall of Fame does it too. So I think the one in here. Yeah, so I got this big sounding room reverb with a bit of chorus on it. Mm-hmm. It's perfect for all the Pink Floyd type of stuff we do, like it. Click on that, and these are all the effects that are available for beaming directly into the amp. So there's a couple of different ones. You got a bass drive, which is like an overdrive distortion type of effect. Chorus, there's a flange octave effects. The compressor out of the RH750 has been tone printed, so you can. There's like three different types of compressors.
Very cool.
And the fun one here is combined. So they've combined. Compression and drive.
How do you control the parameters? Like once you put
like subtle comp and drive, so you can add control. So it's like two tone prints in one. And those are for the bass amps.
Kind
of neat. So again, it's. Mismatch and this starts overheating. It's got an internal overload that'll shut the amp off before it
comes. Cool.
But if you're on a gig, it won't shut off the DI. So the amp is okay. So you still have bass coming in front of the house. It's just once the amp cools down, it'll kick back on.
That's all she wrote for today, folks. Hope you enjoyed it. If you didn't, well, nothing I can do about that, can I? Cheers.